Good morning, good day, good night, good afternoon, wherever you are on this day. We just want to bless the Lord. Glory to God. Welcome to Real Talk, Rise and Shine. And my name is Vivienne. I am coming to you live from out of Toronto, Canada. Before I say what I want to say, listen to a little bit of this.
You did not create me to worry.
No, he didn't.
You did not create me to fear. But you created me to worship daily, so I'ma leave it all right here. Help me say it.
You did not create me to worship.
No, he didn't. He did
you
not.
You did not create
yes.
Create me to fear.
It is not the time to fear.
You created
but
me.
You created me.
God and not another. Glory to God. Good morning to the world. Good night. Good evening. Wherever you are listening to me from, a good day. It is the Lord's day and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Trust that you're up and thankful this morning, embracing it in all its fullness. Glory to God. Just think about it. He was here before you got here and made everything right, put everything in place for you. Yes, and I, so we need to be grateful. Yes, unto the sovereign God. I'm thankful that I'm alive. I've been up from like around 4:30 this morning. And just before I head out, I just wanted to stop by and just bless up on each and every one of you. Again, greetings to all of you who follow me on Facebook, on Instagram, here on YouTube. Glory to God. And also good... and also greetings to those of you on WhatsApp. God bless you. Glory to God. I'm not going to be before you long, but I just want to encourage us. Glory to God. Yeah. It's time for you to open your mouth and speak. Yeah. Open your mouth. Yeah, open your mouth wide. Glory to God. And speak. Yeah, because guess what? You are a speaking being. That is a unique gift that God has given you, the ability to speak. Glory to God. Yes. Oh my God. Could you imagine? I can't even imagine what would have happened if the Creator did not open his mouth. Yeah. If he didn't open his mouth, you and I will still be locked in. Glory to God. If he did not open his mouth, there would be no cars, there would be no houses, there would be no trees, there would be no animals. If he did not open his mouth and speak, there would be no universe. Oh, glory to God. There is power in a spoken word. And you have that ability, that unique gift, glory to God, to speak. So why are you not using your words? Or that ability to speak? And if you are, what kind of words are you speaking? What is coming out of your mouth? We got to be careful, glory to God, what we're speaking out of our mouth. Because remember, yes, there is life and death in the power of our words. Glory to God. Words are powerful. Yes, you can open your mouth and speak words that will be a blessing to you. And we can open our mouth and speak words that will cause damnation, that will go against us. Glory to God. So we got to be careful of what we're saying. Now, I want you to just sit back today. And I want you to either write out or, you know, however you want to memorize it, everything that is in opposition to you, that is opposing you, everything that is opposing your destiny, you from going forward, glory to God, everything that is against your destiny, and you need to speak to it. Speak to whatever is in opposition to where or what you know God has promised you. Use your words, open your mouth and speak the word of God. Yes, speak an active word, speak in a productive word, speak a word that comes in alignment, glory to God, to the advancement of the kingdom of God concerning your life. We bless the name of the Lord. Words are, again, as I said, they are powerful, whether it be good or whether it be bad. Whether you speak it on behalf of the kingdom of God or you speak it on behalf of the kingdom of darkness, it is powerful. Glory to God. So you are in a situation right now. Be careful of the words that you speak. Glory to God. You can't go around and say, you know, I am poor. Glory to God. Because then that is what's going to come back to you. Glory to God. Just like God said, let there be light. You understand? When you say, I am poor, that is what you're saying. So that is what's going to come upon you. Glory to God. Yes, I am sick. You are already speaking. Those are powerful words. But listen, those words go against, glory to God, that which God has spoken. Those words oppose what God has spoken to you. So that is what we need to do. We need to look and to see everything that's opposing us, everything that that is coming against that which is for us. We need to speak it. Now, I want to remind us, as I did a while back, you understand, faith. You know, speak to the mountain, open your mouth. You can't think to the mountain. You got to speak. You got to open your mouth. You got to speak the words. What do you want the mountain to do? Where do you want the mountain to go? Glory to God. Because when we open our mouth and we speak it, then it is the responsibility of God to perform on behalf of the word that you spoke it. Glory to God. So that's why we can speak to our mountain and tell it to remove itself. Get out of my way because you are in opposition. You're opposing me. Yes, and where I need to go. So you got to, again, speak to it with confidence. Don't speak to it like wavering and saying, I wonder if it's going to move. No. When you speak the word, you got to know that, guess what? This is an active word, and that's why we have to be careful. It's an active word, it's in a productive word. So that means it is going to perform, or what I'm speaking and believing is going to happen, because it's an active word. It's not a stagnant word. It's not an improductive word. It's a productive word. And also it lines up with what God has already spoken over my life. Glory to God. So I want to encourage us today. Open your mouth and start talking. Glory to God. Start talking. I'm not talking stupidness. And when I say stupidness, not talking idle words. Glory to God. Idle words, as I said, are inactive. They're not productive. And all of those words, we're going to have to give an account for on the day of judgment. Oh, yeah. So be careful of what you're saying this season. I'm telling you, you got to be careful. And because we got to be careful when we speak, we also got to be careful what we're thinking. Glory to God. The thoughts, because you will, if you're thinking negative thoughts, you're going to speak negative thoughts. Negative words are going to come out of your mouth. Glory to God. So our thoughts also have to come in alignment with our words, which has to come in alignment with God's, what God has already spoken. Glory to God. It doesn't matter if you're not seeing what you're thinking, still speak it. Glory to God, because then God will perform it. It will come to pass. As long as it lines up and it comes in agreement, glory to God, with what he has to say. Let's be careful. All right. Again, we look at the prophet Ezekiel, you know, when he's caught up in the spirit and brought down in the valley of dry bones, and there God could have spoken to those bones. You think God couldn't speak to them? He could have. And even the prophet knew that too. But what was God trying to do? He was trying to say, listen, open your mouth. You speak to it. Glory to God. I am not going to speak to it. You are going to speak to it. All I'm going to do is when you open your mouth, I am going to perform it. That which you speak, I will bring it into pass. Glory to God. You know, could you imagine, you might say, and I was thinking this morning before I came on, I said, you have unsaved people. They don't acknowledge God. They don't even, some of them don't even think there's a God. But guess what? Everything that they say, it comes, it happens. Everything that they put their mind to, it happens. Why? Because they are practicing this principle. Glory to God. Knowing that words are powerful. Glory to God. Because remember, the unsaved, the unregenerated, they have that ability to speak too. Glory to God. And they're going to speak and God is going to respond, because God is responding to the word, especially, you understand, when it comes in alignment, God, with the things of the kingdom. They might not even be in the kingdom, but God is still responding to their word. It's positive. It's active. It's productive. Glory to God. So when we say like, oh, unsaved people are prospering, whatever, maybe because their words are spoken with faith, with confidence and believe. So God is responding to it. We bless the name of the Lord. It's just like how God can heal a person with cancer that's not saved, because they believe the word. When somebody says, open your mouth and believe God for your healing, repeat after me, and they're repeating after me. That is powerful word. That's an active word that is going to come to pass, and they get healing. Come on, somebody. So the prophet spoke, glory to God, to the bones, and God responded. The prophet spoke, glory to God, to the winds, and God allowed it to happen. Because remember, we can't allow anything to happen, but we have to open our mouth. Could you just be in your situation because you refuse to open your mouth? And maybe you are opening your mouth, but it's the wrong words you're saying. Come on, somebody. Let us speak the word. Words are powerful. Words are our weapon. Yes, let us use it wisely. We bless the name of the Lord. Glory to God. So I want to encourage us with that. One of the things I also want to encourage us today is that you are on a narrow path. We are on a narrow path right now. And I want us to keep focus, remain focused, keep your eyes fixed on the prize. Glory to God. The road is narrow. It's so narrow. Some of us can't even fit. We're getting bruised on every side. You know, we probably fall down. And sometimes we feel like you're lonely. Nobody's with us. But you need to stay the course on that narrow path because it leads to eternal life. I don't want you to get distracted. Let us not get distracted of the bling bling. Let us not get distracted of the noise and the boisterous and all that's happening to our left and to our right. We got to remain the course on this narrow path. Glory to God. As I said on yesterday, don't focus on, glory to God, your pursuers while you're on the narrow path. Focus on your leader, glory to God. God is leading you on this path, this journey, this road called life, glory to God. He's there to help us, but we need to remain focused, glory to God. We need to continue to trust him. We need to continue to believe in him, and we need to take him at his word. Words are so powerful. That's why he said he honors his word above all the names we can call him. He will perform it. He will bring it to pass. Words are powerful, glory to God. And we've seen, glory to God, what words can do. How many of us have said, oh, you know, my son and what, listen, this and that and whatever. That is a power pack word there. Believe it or not, that word has power and it will perform. So sometimes we got to check and see, you know, if we've caused these storms in our lives by the words that we've spoken out of our mouth, by what we thought. Glory to God. We bless the name of the Lord. The enemy has access. I'm telling you this. He has access to place things in our thoughts. He does. But guess what? When he places those seed, we have to give consent to them. Yeah, we have to give consent. We have to give the enemy permission to act out those negative thoughts. Glory to God. So we got to not give him consent. So when the enemy puts that seed, a negative seed or thought, and you better not open your mouth and speak that. You got to now reverse the order and speak the word of God. Speak an active, a productive word of God that overrides that thought that wanted to come out of your mouth in the fashion of a word. We bless the name of the Lord. Because again, words are powerful. That saying that says, oh, sticks and stones can hurt my bones, but words or something like that can never hurt me. Something like that, like, yeah, words can hurt people. Words are powerful. Glory to God. You're in a situation, you're in an atmosphere. Use your words to change your atmosphere, making it conducive for a miracle. You have that in you. You've been given the authority by God. Use the words. Have we been speaking the wrong words over our city? Have we been speaking the wrong words over a nation? Have we been speaking the wrong words over our lives? Glory to God. So now that which we've spoken, that which we're seeing, glory to God. So we got to check the words that comes out of our mouth because it's powerful. It's spirit and it's life, whether it is for good or whether it's for bad. We bless the name of the Lord. So while you're on your journey, on this narrow path, be careful of your vocabulary. Be careful of what comes out of your mouth. Be careful of the seed that's implanted in your thoughts. Glory to God. Because you will think it, you will speak it, and then you will act it out. We bless the name of the Lord. So I just want to encourage us this morning. Be careful of the words that we speak. Glory to God. Because it can justify us or it can also condemn us. Yes, so be careful. Be very careful, glory to God. Let us make sure that when we speak, and we say to ourselves, I'm about to say something. Is this an active word? Is this a productive word? And not only that, does this come in conjunction, glory to God, with the kingdom and advance in the kingdom of God? Those are the things we've got to ask ourselves. The days of just opening your mouth and blabbing, blabbing, blabbing. And when you finish, it don't make no sense. It's not active. It's stagnant. It's not productive. Glory to God. You know, might as well you just shut your mouth or we just shut our mouth. We bless the name of the Lord. So again, speak to your mountain. Glory to God. Speak to those dead things in your life. Glory to God. And again, speak to everything that's in opposition. Glory to God, to what you know God has promised you. Speak to it and God will perform that which is spoken over it. All right. So I do open chest that you are blessed by this today as we encourage one another in the Lord. Glory to God. Because again, as I said, that's why it's so important that we read the word of God. That's why it's so important that we study the word of God. So then we're able, glory to God, to use it against the adversary, because words are our weapon. When the enemy comes upon us, it's the word of God that we need to use, glory to God. We need to remind him, glory. You can't come in agreement when the enemy says, you're this and you're that. You said, I am. No, you got to use the word of God and counteract and reverse and throwing in his face. And when it hits him, you understand, it comes like an atomic bomb. Just blow him to smithers. Glory to God. Although, you know, he'll come back again, but at least then you hit him with another one again. Glory to God. And you keep doing that. You understand? Because his job is to weary us down. Glory to God. But let us weary him down with the word of God and then walk in victory, because he did not create you to worry or to create you to fear, but to trust him. Glory to God. So be blessed on today. Be encouraged. We serve an awesome God. We're going to be going soon. Glory to God with our declaration song, not just over you, but over your entire family. Glory to God. But before I do, I just want to put in a plug, glory to God, here for those of you who are in the Greater Toronto area, Mississauga, Brampton, glory to God. On December 4th, glory to God, KRBM Ministries, Sister June Phoenix is putting on a prayer breakfast under the theme Survival. My God, survival. Have you survived anything? Have you survived anything? Yeah. With the grace of God, yes. Have you survived anything? Well, this is Survival Breakfast. It's on Saturday, December the 4th. Glory to God at its starting time, I believe. I don't see a time on the flyer. Oh, yes, I do. 10 a.m. Glory to God. The address will be 180 Wilkinson Drive. Glory to God. No, just $15. Glory to God. Yes, $15. You know, if you're interested, connect with me, or you can send your e-transfer along with a note, your name, to Lady June 15.N as in Norma, P as in Phoenix, M as in Mercy @gmail.com. Yes, yours truly, myself, God will be a special guest there. Glory to God, encouraging the believers. You see, it's one thing when we gather to eat all this food for the natural man, but guess what? You got to feed the spirit man too. Glory to God, because trust me, if you just feed the flesh, you understand, when things come upon you, only fleshy word you ever give. Glory to God. But when you feed the spirit man, yeah, when the enemy comes, trust me, you just lace him with the word of God. So join us on December 4th if you're able to. It's for a good cause. Glory to God. It's not because I'm the speaker why I'm doing that. Glory to, or I'm announcing it. Even if I wasn't, I would, because again, it's for a good cause. Let us come out. Let us celebrate. Let us eat some spiritual food and also some natural food. Glory to God. So again, that is December 4th at 10 a.m. Glory to God. 180 Wilkinson Avenue. Glory to God. Sorry about that. And it's $15. So looking forward to seeing you there. Definitely, God has a word for us. You know, I've been seeking the Lord. Glory to God, asking him, what would he have me to say? Glory to God, to his people at this time, a crucial time that we're in, a pandemic, people losing their job, you know, people are dying, natural causes, people are being murdered. You know, we have a mudslide in BC, you know, earthquakes and wars and rumors of wars. God, what would you have us to say under this theme, survival? You must survive. You are a survivor. Glory to God. So come on, let's celebrate and let's do this. All right, we're going.
The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace.
My God. we need the peace of God more than anything. Yes.
The Lord bless you.
No one can curse you.
And keep.
He's the one that's keeping us.
Make his face.
I am thanking him that his face is shining upon us and he is gracious to us. Yes, his face towards us today. And grant us his peace, not the peace of the world, but his peace. Oh, the peace of God we can rest in it today. Amen. Because we come in agreement. Oh, yes, Lord.
Amen.
Remember to pray for the sick and the afflicted. Let us remember to pray for souls. Yes. And that God will send more laborers. For truly, the harvest is ripe.
The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace.
Hallelujah.
We agree. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. Favor be upon you. We bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Yes. May his favor.
May his favor be upon you for the thousand generations.
Your family
and your children and their children.
Yes, indeed. It was a pleasure serving you on today with clean hands and a pure heart and a right motive. Glory to God. Wherever you are around the world, remember, you have the heart of a champion, the mind of an overcomer, and the spirit of more than a conqueror. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Remember, you are a lit candle. Go out and light your world on today. Glory to God. And remember, glory to God, our words are our weapons. Glory to God. They are powerful. Glory to God. It's spirit and it's life. Be careful of what is coming out of our mouths, glory to God, because we shall have what we say, whether good or bad, glory to God. So be blessed on today. Have yourself a wonderful day, glory to God. Again, our greetings to each and every one of you. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you for supporting. And thank you for those who subscribe. And thank you for those who continue to share. Glory to God. Be blessed on today. He is for us. Yes. Grace and peace be unto everyone, nothing lacking and nothing.